When you want to bake a focaccia, the best way is actually to start with the spiced oil you want to put on it. The herbs and the spices, they take a while to diffuse into the oil. So start up with a lot of rosemary. I just chop it coarsely. And with the smaller spices, like thyme and oregano, I peel off the leaves. Just put that directly into the oil. Medium-sized leaves like mint, lemongrass and stuff like that, I chop up coarsely. And larger leaves like basil, I pull into a bundle and cut it into fine stripes. That way they'll all be the same size approximately. And the same with parsley. The garlic is kind of roughly chopped. If it's too fine, it'll burn too easily on the bread. If it's a little rough, it'll taste better. So this should just be heated up with the oil. And when all the leaves are flattened and soggy, the oil is ready. It doesn't have to burn, it shouldn't boil. And so on to the bread mixture. Baker's yeast, around the size of a pea. Water. I just put in a little water to begin with so I can get the yeast all over and mixed in well, and then I put in the rest of the water and then the flour. And then I wait a little while and put in the salt so the salt doesn't come in direct contact with the yeast. That could kill off the yeast theoretically. It doesn't happen, but better safe than sorry. And when it has this consistency, it's as it should be. No kneading is required, it just needs to be mixed. And so it has leavened for about 12 hours. And it's a very wet dough, so you need to treat it quickly and have a lot of flour on the table and on your fingers. And then quickly fold it together. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. That way and that. And then you shape it into a ball. Just press it in the bottom. Then we'll put that on a baking pan to rise once more. And to help it make it rise evenly, I'll just soak it with a bit of oil. Put it on your hands. And then pat the surface down so it's nice and glistening. That will make it expand evenly and easily. So about 1.5 hours later, put on the spiced oil, a little to begin with so my fingers doesn't stick when I do this. This is to prevent the spiced oil to flow from the bread. Put on the rest. Like that. And if there are any tops or it needs to be distributed a little more evenly, you just do that. Just don't press out the gas. It just needs to push it down, not poke holes in it. And then a little less than a teaspoon of salt and drizzle it over. Then it must rise another 1/2 hour. And usually you can bake it in a pan like this, but I have a cast iron pizza stove and it's absolutely brilliant for the job. It has a small edge that prevents the oil from sipping into the oven. And this stone is hot when I put on the dough. It's out of the right out of the oven. And then half an hour later, at 200 degrees Celsius, it's done. Well, actually, by mistake, I gave this 250 degrees, but it's still made a darn fine bread. So, enjoy.